Residents are also growing concern as some of the hazardous waste arrives at a landfill in Putnam County.
And one congressman from Indiana is demanding a pause on those deliveries until we know exactly what's inside them. Fox 59 Chief Investigator Steve Brown explains what has been found.
Congressman Jim Baird wants a timeout.
We want to pause the delivery until we make sure that EPA and the Department of Transportation, that we do the appropriate testing so we know what materials are coming, like dioxin and how much, if it's there.
At least three deliveries have arrived at the Heritage Waste Storage Facility in Putnam County. In those deliveries, material collected at the site of the train wreck in East Palestine, Ohio.
Dioxin needs to be incinerated.
Local residents have been frustrated over the slow flow of information about those shipments.
How many people here heard the material was coming via social media or the news?
When you don't have the appropriate information and have the details, then you start to making guesses about what it is, and many times that's wrong.
There is some information available from the EPA. In soil and sediment samples collected at the scene of the train wreck, trichloromethane, vinyl chloride, and xylenes have all been identified, all substances considered hazardous by the Federal Occupational Safety and Health Administration. Attorney General Todd Rokita says he's gotten some information about the shipments and offers this.
It's certainly more friendly relative, frankly, to a lot of other materials that very same landfill has been accepting for years.
Governor Eric Holcomb yesterday announced a Minnesota company, Pace Analytics, would independently test material brought to the Putnam County facility. And while Baird appreciates the added state scrutiny, he'd like to see greater disclosure.
I just feel that those agencies have a responsibility to inform the local people, and that's what I'd like to see happen.
As far as Baird's desire to pause those shipments, that appears unlikely. Attorney General Rokita says, based on his review, those shipments conform with state and federal law. Steve Brown, Fox 59 News.
Steve, thank you.